5% of the league.
I'll give you that.
Mm-hmm.
Four vertical.
Four verts, that's my money play. I ain't gonna lie to y'all, that's what I do. I ain't gotta hide shit. Only two people in here can stop it. And even then, I can still do pretty good with them. Oh shit. I almost died.
Oh, bullshit. Oh, man. See, if that
would've
been fucking Hopkins, that
would've
been dope.
I love getting speed.
That's where it's at, dude. Oh my god, he stuttered like a motherfucker.
Oh shit, I got one person on. Who's out here watching my stream? You want y'all fuckers? No introduction really necessary. Get to miss it like a secretary, boy, I'm legendary. When I'm dead, bears, they be kicking flavor in the cemetery. My prediction is Colts 35, Raiders 7. Damn, the Jags hit the left. I pissed him off by trying to steal a quarterback, huh? I don't even really want him. I'm just trying to make him pay more. Is that fucked up? I don't even think
there was no reason to anger him in that way, son. Let him know. Everyone knows I'm going.
Squad? I think she beat my hand. We to the man at Lana head cop to the left turn to the back. Try to see we weren't having that. Sit with your head dropping the Alabama at. And we keep on trying to battle around. Be one in there. No drive. We ready. Yo, I don't like that music. It's unholy.
I know. The good part about it. I mean, hell, their name is Suicide Boys. What do you expect?
I think the Jags is about to join that squad.
Hell yeah, yeah, son. See? Exactly. That's my favorite shit. I love me some Ruby.
See y'all on that shit.
Oh, yeah.
I'm just fucking dude, I don't care what you listen to. I mainly just listen to fucking sports talk shows anyway in the car.
For sure.
Nah, fuck Russell Flat, fuck country.
Fucking A, dude! Fucking A!
Man, aren't y'all the ones from Missouri? I know y'all the ones listening to the country out here.
Well, fuck that, Missouri. You guys be Colorado's a hell of a lot more country than
Thank
we are.
Thank you, Coach. Uh-uh. Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to Oakland, California.
Colorado's hood, bro.
So, Jags really left? Party.
Montbello.
The robbery. Look at the chain. I'm so sorry.
play fight. See sign break night. This break night. My wrist watch is like a break. Yo, who do y'all think is the best rapper? Best rapper.
Like alive or like
alive.
Of all time?
Alive.
Yeah. That's the other thing.
Hip hop.
Well, wow, you are fucking country.
It's J. Cole. That's the answer I'm looking for.
Yep. Yep.
Thank you. As long as you don't say Kendrick, we're good.
Yeah, you mean tell me fucking down south, Midwest,
M is pretty good.
M's my favorite lyricist, period. He's the greatest of all time.
M's good, bro.
Handle your business. Handle your business. Loyal and honor, don't break no bro codes. The more red rose, match with the rose gold. Whoever counted me out, they can't count. Oh.
Yeah, and I like 2K. I mean, it depends on the mood, too. If I'm stoned,
thank you, Coach.
EA
Sports coverage
future.
Of the NFL brings us to.
We know you're out here listening to Tech 9, bro.
Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it. This crowd is ready.
That's good, all right.
It's just crazy challenge to look to heavy metal for me. His rap shit, like fucking.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchdown.
New Tech is pretty garbage, though.
You here, get this. Wrap your head around this one. Tech is the, like, highest selling artist, independent artist of all time. The dude. Merchandise, CDs, and ticket sales all together is the, like, has the greatest, like, he sold the most more than any other performer. That, even the Beatles and Elvis.
It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Yeah.
But we just saw
that's
a great
right.
example of what we talked about with his coach prior
son.
To the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading
yeah,
the play and
like
flowing to make the
total,
stop before it turns into something
like merchandise,
big.
A loss of a yard there to start
sales,
out. That leads
combined.
To a second and 11.
He fucking surpasses the Beatles. So, he's doing something
it's
right.
always tough for the guys throwing it's the football.
Right
and they
now.
Think they've got a completion, and the ball's almost yeah. there, and then
yeah.
someone sneaks
true.
A hand or two in and bats it away.
Everybody loves him. I mean, dude.
A little trouble thus far on their
hardcore
opening drive as they come up on a third and 11.
All the way to heavy metalwork. I mean, how brilliant is that to fucking expand genres like that? You know, and to do that.
The Colts are gonna get him.
I had to give it back to you because that last one was going.
Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
And taken right at the 35.
Like
21 yards. Well done on the return. And the Colts are set up well as they take over first and 10 on the short side of the field.
The Colts are proud of how good this dude is whenever I play him. The Colts is the real shit.
Now a first down throw. Locke finding a safety valve here. That's complete.
What the hell, y'all? Come on.
A very solid gain of 27. Just the first quarter of attack.
I don't like how my dude looks to do and they don't do it.
Going forward, they've got to limit plays like that.
And that's something when you see it happen early in the game and they don't get him on the ground, you can always
rough.
Tell that they were concerned about it going in. Because I can just tell you, from my days, I remember being in college and worrying all offseason about our season open opponent, and they had a receiver that could shake and bake with the best of them. I tackled him on the first pass of the game, and the relief was incredible.
Oh,
a pretty decent ball.
Oh, come on. I was there if you just had to throw on that.
Now a three in the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
Quarterbacking 101. never force the ball into double coverage, especially not this close to the goal line. The windows are so tight, you just don't want to force it in there because it could be tipped up and picked off.
Back to the airlock on second down. Funches with a catch over the middle. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders. Hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or
better against man, because now you're running away from someone and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
Yeah, I want to do that. I knew it. Fucking didn't want to do
that. He can run, and the Colts are in for the touchdown. So a quarterback scramble, certainly a pass play, but he saw something, tucked it, and got in the end zone.
A lot of quarterbacks, when they scramble, they're scrambling to create more time to throw the ball downfield. In this situation, as you noted, he tucked it and took off. Great play by him.
Extra point up and good by Sucka. And it's now a 7-0 game. Now here's Sucka out to kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Now the Oakland offense heading back onto the field to take over. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. And they get to Newton and take him down for the sack. Justin Houston in there to bring him down for a loss of 7. Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Out of the gun, Newton escaping the pressure right. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third.
What's the old adage? Be quick, but don't hurry. Well, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed. That ball had to be gotten rid of, otherwise he was going to get sacked.
Newton now to throw. He gets it to Brown. Complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. An excellent pickup of 34 yards. So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. Now a first down throw for Newton. And that's incomplete. Deion Sims is tight end, the intended target. And that'll bring up second down.
Well, they're slinging it. And then there's one you got to put a timer on, huh? I mean, that one came in hot.
That came in hot, but overthrown, out of his reach and incomplete. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. To throw again, Newton steps away to his left. He turned that into a nice gain. Gets him 8 yards closer for third down. So third and 2, this quite possibly four down territory, though, if they're stopped. From the gun, here's Newton. Shakes off the sack, but he can't get away forever, and down he goes. And that is the third sack this offensive line has allowed this first quarter.
Well, that puts him on pace. Let me do the rudimentary math here. To be sacked 12 times in a game, I know he's not going to go for that. I wonder if it's going to reshape what they decide to do on offense in terms of play calling.
Well, I can tell you what, when he popped up, shaking his head, frustrated right now behind center. Hey, nothing to see here. Just your standard fourth down gain of 28 yards. And the drive keeps going. The Raiders into the red zone for the first time. It's first and 10 at the 14. From the red zone now, Newton. And he'll avoid the tackle there with a slide. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with second and a yard.
I think the last two plays really illustrate how difficult it is to game plan against this guy, because you know he can throw the football, but how about his use of legs as well? What we call those broken plays, you can't account for them.
Yeah, those plays, those two that you just mentioned, a microcosm really of how he can hurt you. To throw on second down is Newton. And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. DeAndre Washington, his first touchdown on the year. And the Raiders, they're within an extra point of tying this thing up. Extra point right down the middle. And we are tied at seven.
You know what these is.
So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. This will be taken in at the one. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offensive tummy.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a three and out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that.
And down he goes. Brought down a Raiders sack. They were able to win last week despite him being sacked four times. They might need to tighten the reins a little bit, or this one may not end in another victory.
You're right about that. They can't count on just winning the game no matter what happens. They can't let the accumulation of hits and harassment in the pocket get to their quarterback. Gotta stop that. Give him clean lanes and throw the football in order to have a better chance to win again this week.
They get 16 out of that one, but they'll still need to convert on third. 12. Luck looks to throw on third and one. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he's got the first down yardage as he brings this up to the 47. Oh, the gain is seven, and it gets him a new set of downs.
11 feet. Oh, shit. I hit
on first and 10, Locke.
I think I fucked it up.
And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. So here's a first and 10 now in Raider territory at the 43. Throwing again is Locke. Funches has it complete.
In the goal.
And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. Give him nine there on the first down completion.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
And he'll go down at the 28. Hilton's first catch, good for a first down.
And it all came together there, in breaking route. Drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
On first down, it's Locke. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
My favorite
second and 10. And a hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
Yep. It's a lot of contact going on there, and in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. And now maybe they want some extra time to talk about this third and long play as we'll get a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside
again,
here in this second quarter.
This
offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. To the air again, Locke. That's going to be caught.
It's first down.
And he takes this one in for a Colts touchdown. Eric Ebron, his third touchdown now on the year.
You know?
And the Colts are in for six.
smooth and slow, but hard.
Boy, it's nice to have that big,
like,
reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time, a lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails. Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown.
Belly's one of my favorite, like, black.
Now here's Suck about to kick it away.
Genre movies, I guess.
This is Field at the goal line. And he will be marked down right there at the 20-yard line. And now Oakland ready to take the field. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are. But with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. Doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
Yeah, Christian with fucking what's his nuts? Christopher Walken and fucking Lawrence Fishburne.
On first down, Newton.
Open it up, tampons. What's this one? The pool hole's pulled off.
10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down. So an instance there of Cam being Cam. We know he can use his legs.
And with that big body,
and he brought down by the Colts. Justin Houston in there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Over the middle here to Brown. A really good pickup of 28 yards. We often, with Cam Newton, talk a lot about his legs. Don't forget about that arm.
He can throw it on a rope. He can loft it. He's got the touch that's been developed throughout his career. But the big part about just...
This is caught inside the 15. And he'll be taken down inside Indy's 15-yard line.
That was
an excellent
pickup
of 34 yards. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10.
Good
from the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line.
It was hot.
He'll get five out of the scramble. It's second down.
Yeah, he only gets a few yards on first and 10, but he's better off doing that than throwing an incompletion or even worse, an interception.
Oh, hell no.
Second down. Here's Crowell.
That's some bullshit.
And that
right
one
there.
Blown up quickly as he's going to be stopped before he can even get started. It'll be a loss of one, and it'll be third down.
Come on now.
So do I, but he's old as shit. I really think they fucking his
back to
like,
throw.
The arm strength on here, because I believe
flat.
Like,
that's complete to his running back.
Last
and able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down.
My throwing
nice
is like that. I play the computer all the time, so when I play, this is my first season like playing against people. So I need to get it out of my head that quit playing
down.
Like I'm playing the computer.
Take it in.
Dude, this is my first time ever being in a league with other people.
Isaiah Crowell.
Yeah, see, I've always been
touchdown
the computer.
On the year. And the Raiders have drawn even
so
here.
Other than, like, local shit, you play your homeboys. Outside of that, I've never... This is my first time playing online and shit.
Setting out a kick this other away, people. And off it goes.
He's doing a stream, I think. So he muted it.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Here comes the Indianapolis offense now as they get set to take over. Look, and the Colts come up now first and 10
concert.
At their own 25-yard line.
Out
of the gun, Luck.
I know I suck.
He's going to loft this one deep left sideline.
Yeah, that's
so
what they
took
to do
a
for
shot
real.
On first down, but couldn't connect.
Turn on safe mode and...
A minute 58 to go in this first half of play.
I can't remember what they call it.
We'll come back to Oakland.
It's basically like
this.
Wiping your cash out and resetting. But it doesn't erase anything except for all the bad shit. All the little micro shit.
Second and
10,
Luck again.
But my controller was doing the same thing, and I went and bought
looking
a new one.
Looking deep for Craig, and that's caught inside the 35.
Still
a huge play that time for the Colts.
After about
41 yards.
So,
I'd have to say that whenever you see a good post route run,
like I do
they
with everything.
They do not like to let it in without
read everything
the
I
catch.
About it.
Hence, that great diving play.
Yeah, lay it out there, let him go get it, and he got it. On the right side, it's Hilton with a catch. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. That throw good for four. It's second down.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going
to ask you, that wasn't the primary target, and he's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
They'll run it here. This is Marlon Mack. And he will have the first before he's brought down right on the chalk of the 20. They get five out of that one, and it moves the chains.
That's quite a spot there for his first carry of the game, but obviously they had plenty of faith in him, didn't they?
No question about it here. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Indianapolis. A great effort there. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Colts are in for six.
Dude, that's like fucking Major League with fucking Wesley Snipes fucking slide short.
Extra point through by Succop. And the decision to just that's kick hilarious. The extra point winds up successful.
Yeah. See, at least I didn't call another play like fucking gang shit, goddammit. I don't think he was paying attention. I think he was just fucking doing it. It was a good recovery. The motherfucker just didn't know the game was over.
Now here's Succop out to kick it away.
All right, so the options are restart, change, resolution, update
fielded
system
about
software.
A yard deep.
You want to rebuild database. Number five. Don't initialize, because initialize
and
they wipe your entire
down here at about the 17-yard line.
Option five,
the Raiders offense now,
database.
They trot back out.
And
what do you think goes on here in this situation?
Off,
if you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory
off,
with just a little time. Do you try something?
USB,
you're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned they're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure,
you'll hit start or you hit power,
you may put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second.
Fucking safe
managing
to pop
risk.
Up.
This is
and
a big decision
to
here.
Rebuild database. It'll do it by itself, and it'll be done. You can turn that off.
It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
No.
D.D. Westbrook, his intended receiver.
And, you'll
and
hear first
bring up
beat
second
when
down.
You press it.
Well, partner, they're not contending on this one out as we head towards the half, trying to hit a big chunk play right there and add to their score.
Yeah, this is a confident group at the very
least.
Yeah,
you got to have the controller plugged in.
So
you
want to
do the power button on the PlayStation itself.
And now we won't see
it.
You got to
have the controller plugged in, or it won't let you go in.
As the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half.
All right.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Now Newton on first down. And it's complete. The tight end, Deion Sims. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. As they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half. Newton now closing in on a 200-yard first half through the air. It's first and 10. Here's Newton. His throw caught right around the 6. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Throwing again is Newton. Feeling the pressure here and taken down. A sack back at the 7. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. This clearly the final play of the half, but no field goal attempt. They're going for it with 3 seconds remaining. A final shot before the break. Newton. And that is caught. Touchdown, Raiders. Antonio Brown. As time expires in the first half, And the Raiders have drawn even here, and they can take the lead with the extra point to come. Pinheiro now to add the extra point. The extra point up and good. So we've reached halftime in a wild first half. We'll take a minute to catch our breath as we'll send you back over to Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Here's Jonathan Coachman. Kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. Now he's into the clear. The 30, 10, touchdown Indianapolis. In for the score. And the Colts are in for six.
We've sat in a lot of meetings, and they always talk about the offense taking advantage of beginning a half. The special teams coaches don't listen to that. They want to take advantage with their own unit, and they just did.
Yeah, they trailed in the locker rooms, and they changed that immediately.
I think they drew that one up special. That felt like something he pulled out of his pocket that he'd been holding for a while, and they were able to use it effectively.
Extra point up and good by Succop. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. So let's try this again. After the kick return TD, here's yet another kickoff. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. So here comes the Raiders offense getting ready for their first possession of the second half. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete.
Well, I guess we just discovered that someone is certainly not going to sit back and just take it in this game, huh?
No, they were trying to get that touchdown back in one shot.
One shot, trying to help out his defense and let the other team know they were coming after him.
To the air, Newton on second down. That's into the hands of Westbrook over the middle. The 20. And he's in. Touchdown, Raiders. A big play there. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Raiders have drawn even here. They can take the lead with the extra point to come. Pinheiro now to add the extra point. Extra point safely through, and that will put them on top here in the third. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Now the Colts offense gets ready to head back on the field. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Luck on first down. And he'll be wrapped up around the waist and pushed down. Whitney Merciless coming hard on the blitz. He dumps him for a loss of 8. So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. A shotgun snap for Luck. Trying to improvise. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. That one goes for 36 yards.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play. They picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
On first down, Luck. Ebron caught left side. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide him. With the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
This has been an up-and-down, back-and-forth type of a game, hasn't it? Maybe this long drive took a little bit of the wind out of their sails, kind of settled things down a little bit.
On second down, here's Love. Forced out to his left. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
It's not like pressure to affect the accuracy and the timing of a guy trying to throw the football. And on that play, they ended up flushing him to his left, contacted him as he's trying to throw the football, and that led to the incompletion.
Throwing on third down, Luck. His pass caught at the 4. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
Nice catch right there. Brings to mind the sentence, when in doubt, find your veterans.
I used to laugh back in the day when they would call guys like him crafty veterans. You get up in your 30s, you're still playing receiver. And he takes it in for a Colts score. A great play there. His 2nd touchdown of the afternoon. And the Colts are in for 6. So now Luck is going to bring the Colts up here to go for the 2-point try. From the gun, here's Luck. And that is caught for the 2 points. And, of course, on the 2-point try, had the option to run or pass. They pass it there, and it works.
Felt pretty straightforward, didn't it? An open receiver, ball's put on him, 2 points for them.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. So out come the Raiders. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
On first down, it's Newton. Got a man, it's Brown. Nice move at the 40. And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask. So the face mask, quite a blessing there as they'll start out of harm's way with a first and 10. Out of the gun, Newton. Flushed out right. Now he's going to throw it deep to the other side. This is caught inside the 15. And he'll be taken down inside Indy's 15-yard line. Give him 30 yards there. And we continue to see another example here of offenses just going for it.
And this game is really turning.
And oh, it'll be intercepted. Snags it for the pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
As much football as we watch, we've seen this work many times. In the red zone, first down, take a shot at the end zone, and points result. In this case, though, give credit to the defense. They outguessed them, were prepared, and intercepted the pass.
After the interception, it's long. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup.
How about that scramble by Andrew Luck? Sometimes we forget just how big, strong, and yes, fast Andrew Luck is. When he came out of college at the combine, shocked everyone, ran a sub 4.840.
And he grew up a big soccer guy over in Europe, so he knows how to use his feet.
That he does, and I think it's helped his legs along the way as well.
And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
But that's what you're looking for when you're wanting to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
Slips up past the 45 before being tackled. That's good for an Indianapolis first down on a gain of 10. Now, I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense.
And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down.
Hindsight is 20-20, partner. Maybe they should have kept it on the ground again.
Well, it almost looked like the O-line was run-blocking again. I mean, they opened up a big hole last time. This time they opened up a hole, and the quarterback got sacked. So after the sack, they'll come up on a still manageable second and 13. Luck now to throw. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Danny Trevathan, and he'll get this one out to the 50 to the midfield stripe. A critical error there in a tight game of the fourth.
All you talk about is taking care of the football, and especially with a lead here in the fourth quarter, turning it over, now the door is open for the opposition.
Just in general, when you're passing in the fourth quarter with a lead, no matter at what point, you got to be super careful.
Got to be careful, and sometimes you can be so careful that you end up running yourself into an error.
Here's Newton now on second down. Being chased out left. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. Newton able to use those legs and get past the marker to pick up the first.
How many times have we seen this late in the fourth quarter? Because you know the pass rush is getting after him, and they get upfield, get that great push. And what do they create? Space. And he takes off.
Here's Newton. Steps away to his left. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
So many times we talk about having good eye discipline when you're playing defense, making sure your eyes are in the proper place on a given play. Looks like that discipline came to the front there, didn't it? They were able to hold him for a short gain when he took off running.
On second down, here's Newton. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. And they went for a big play through the air on second down. Couldn't connect. Now it's third.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. A shotgun snap for Newton. eluding the pressure right. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 16. Charles, whatever's going on between his ears right now, it's just not completely calculated correctly. Seven picks between last week and this week after that one.
And they always say the most important part of a player is those 6 inches between the ears. But right now, it's all those interceptions that are going on. So whoever his trusted confidant is on the sidelines, I don't know if it's the offense coordinator, quarterback's coach, maybe the backup quarterback, that's who he needs to get with now and get himself calm.
Mack to start the drive. And he'll take this up only to about his 18-yard line. Carl Joseph up from his safety spot to make the play.
Brandon, you know how many times we've done games, and at the start of the fourth quarter, we see both teams hold up the four fingers, fourth quarter is ours. Well, how about this drive? You saw the four fingers for four-minute offense, and this offensive line has really hunkered down and established themselves.
Now, this is where they say, put the game on our shoulders, we'll lead the way, right?
No doubt about it. And let me tell you, if you're a running back, all you want to do is get behind those big fellas, have a little vision, and find some space.
And a solid way to do that on the first play of the drive there. Coming up to the line, and they will need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Back to throw. Long. And the Raiders have got him. And now, defensively, they're going to burn their first timeout. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the two-minute warning. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. To throw is long. And he's going to go down again. And now this defense trying to use the clock to their advantage. They'll take the timeout here with 2:08 left. And then they'll have another stop coming up at the two-minute warning. Luck and the Colts looking for something big here after the sack. This is third and long. Here's Luck. He's going to air one out. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning. Hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play. And the officials are instructed, if there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. Back to throw. Dancing to his left. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. The Raiders try to move quickly, try to get everybody back to the line.
This has been a tough one for this offensive line. It appears almost like they've been on roller skates this entire game, the way they've been pushed around. Six sacks given up in this one.
It's caught inside the 25. And all the way in. Touchdown, Oakland. A big play there with his second touchdown of the game and fifth on the year. And the Raiders, they're within an extra point of tying this thing up. Now a big two-point conversion attempt still to come. They'll look to throw. His pass caught in the four. And this one incomplete, but a flag down here on the play. And this might be offsides. If it is, they're going to get another shot. And another timeout taken by the Colts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Here we go now as we get set for a big two-point conversion. They'll try the sneak. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup.
I know there's some time on the clock, but I still think you kick the extra point there and don't go for two and go for the win in that spot.
Yeah, time or no time, why not just take the one and even the score?
And then that way, no matter what, at least you know what you're dealing with now. It's a whole different strategy. You got to decide whether you're going to onside kick or just try and play defense and get the ball back.
Here comes the Colts offense now as they make their way onto the field. They're up by one. They have the football. The key here, just don't do anything silly, right, Charles?
That's exactly right. And you know all the admonitions as they ran out there. Take care of the ball. Secure everything. Be tight in everything that you do. No let up, no crazy plays, and they can go home with a victory.
Let's see here if they can do all those things and hang on to this victory. This, in all probability, another run here on second and eight. Luck gonna throw it. Over the middle here, it's Hilton. Luck able to find Hilton there for a Colt first down. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Luck. On the right side, it's Hilton with the catch. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
And they're going to take it all the way down and just take the delay. And that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves them back five. The delay of game backs them up five, first and 15. So Luck down to a knee, and that ought to be the final act of this ball game. And the clock will roll down to zeros. 4 weeks in, 4-0. I don't think anybody needs to alert the 72 Dolphins just yet, but great start to the season.
Great start. How about taking a knee at the end? And there's no better feeling for a team than to do that, to close out a victory. But you're right, at 4-0, they're sending a message to the rest of the league. They're going to be tough to deal with.
A lot of scoring. There's no doubt about that in this one, Charles. Points, they were not at a premium. They were pretty easy to come by.
They were, but it was fun, wasn't it? Because both teams finding ways to click. And you know people who love this game, they also love baseball games that are 14-11 with three or four home runs mixed in.
So for the Colts, hey, they finish a perfect month of September as they move to 4-0 on the new campaign. And they'll head back home next week to take on the Buffalo Bills. Meanwhile, for Oakland, they'll fall back to 500 at 2-2. And they'll try to get back to their winning ways next week as they head to KC to take on the Chiefs. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew here at EA Sports, I'm Brandon Gordon, saying so long, everybody.